special edition of the Boob Tube Buddies podcast featuring our discussion of Away.
Bum, bum, bum.
Right off the bat.
So my intrepid co-host tried his very best throughout the season, but it's time for him to pay the Pied Piper. The two truths, one big little lie game that we've been playing all season came down to the wire, and I won in a squeaker last week. Are you happy that I'm not exaggerating?
Yeah, it was a Richard Smeagol.
It was a very, very good... probably the closest in the history of Boob Tube Buddies. This game really came down to it, but now it's time for the punishment. You ready, buddy?
Yeah.
Okay. You are going to be hosting this podcast.
No.
You're going to host the podcast.
I don't want to host
the podcast.
That's
just what's happening.
I didn't take any notes
or anything. You didn't take any notes, and it's going to be goddamn great.
Why would you do that for the finale?
I will bail you out when is necessary, but you're
going to horrible.
You're
going to
be doing it,
idea.
So here goes.
No, I don't like this. I can't do it.
You have to. That's what the punishment is. Start now. So what do I normally do at this point?
Well, alrighty. Let me get all these things out of the way. Follow us on MySpace and Facebook and Reddit.
Starting with MySpace.
And Twitch and give
Tumblr.
Us money on Patreon.
Uh-huh.
And
Lantern, that's the name
of the episode.
Also,
we have Green Lantern coming out.
No, that's the name of the episode is Lantern.
Oh. This is...
Now you have to introduce me.
Oh, let me meet with... Can we please not?
No, that's what it is. Keep going. Come on. Power through.
I'm J.P. Moore. No, I'm...
He just boxed himself.
No.
Okay, go ahead.
Thank you for joining. I'm Jables, and always is the tick to my toe.
Always is the tick to my toe. Okay.
It's a tick toe. Do you even make sense?
Okay, off to a good start.
Is Adam...
No, I don't use my first name either. Keep going.
Is Foxman.
Okay, very good.
Today we're going to cover Better Call Saul, Season 3, Episode 10, entitled Lantern.
Very good.
The penultimate episode after the ultimate episode.
Yeah, the ultimate. Season finale.
The season finale.
Uh-huh.
Let's start with summing it up in a tweet.
Wait. Scale of 1 to 10.
Oh, so, how did you rate... How do you feel about this? That's a goddamn noise.
Okay,
so rude.
Scale of 1 to 10,
me.
I thought that for season finales, it was good. I didn't think that it was exceptional. So I'm going to give it a season finale 8.5.
Ooh.
But a Better Call Saul 9.5.
Really?
Yeah, because...
Wow,
I think,
numbers were way lower than that.
Yeah, see, because I think that a season finale needs to be more special, I think, than this
one
was.
Yeah, of course.
I mean, I'm probably being kind by calling it a Better Call Saul 9
you're
and a half at
a,
all.
You're being a crazy
you
kind.
You think so?
Oh,
okay.
My God.
All right, let me hear what you got.
I mean, I'd give it a 7.
Wow.
I mean, we'll get into it later, but I mean, what, 20 minutes of it was Chuck searching for wires?
Which I thought was actually a good scene. Like, that was his frenetic energy, and considering what happened at the end, if that really
spoiler
is his
alert.
Demise. What are you talking about? The whole episode is, the whole podcast is spoiling.
Yeah.
I will say in our Fargo podcast this week, I accidentally let loose a really big Wonder Woman spoiler.
Oh, no.
And that's different. Like, we're not trying to spoil things other than the show that we're covering.
No one's going to go see Wonder Woman.
Are you kidding me? Wonder Woman is fucking amazing.
No, I've seen it twice.
Oh,
so
you're being funny?
Dick,
okay,
yeah.
It's so good. Okay, now.
So, thank you for that. Here's summing it up in a tweet. Oh, let me tell you about this little segment we have. You guys all know it. It's from Twitter, and it's 140 characters or less. And we like to call it...
Summing it up in a tweet.
Oh, yeah, we're summing it up. So stop summing it up. Summing it up. Oh, yeah, we're summing it up. Oh, yeah, we're summing it up. So stop summing it up. Summing it up and up.
Tweet.
Welcome back to Summing It Up in a Tweet.
Okay, all right, hold on. Let me just butt in here. That's it for the punishment.
Oh, fucking thank God.
I know the amount of anxiety.
The listeners are rejoicing too, I'm sure.
I know the amount of anxiety that builds up with you when you feel like you have to have responsibility for something like that. I know that you really do, like, how did you refer to me that one time? Your bronze-chested baboon.
Oh, God.
I feel like you want me to fireman carry you through every episode.
I truly
episode.
Do. Definitely a wingman.
You're definitely a wingman. Always the bridesmaid. So, anyway, bridesmaid, we can go back to our normal format. Whew. Go ahead and hit me up with your S-I-U-I-A-T.
All right. Finale? More like finally over. Episode was a total dozer. Kim's recovering. Chuck is suffering. Hector ran out of Beano Dozer. Jimmy fell on his sword. Chuck is headed to the Boren Ward.
That is, first off, really fucking sloppy. I didn't understand any of those goddamn words, marble mouth son of a bitch.
I forgot that I rewrote it out on the phone, so halfway through I was like, oh shit, it stops there.
And I felt like you used the same rhyme a bunch of times.
No,
Here, give it to me, let me read it. Give it to me.
You want to read my handwriting instead?
That's a minimum of 200 characters.
No, dude, it's only 26.
Finale, more like finally over. Episode was a dozer. Kim's recovering. Chuck is suffering. Hector ran out of Ben is over. Okay, I see why that was. Okay. Jimmy fell on the sword. Chuck is headed for the burn ward. Okay.
That was much better.
That was okay.
Can you read my stuff from now on?
You just say it like this for some reason.
I got good ideas, but my mouth don't like them.
We by the way, I've been making fun of Jables, well, basically my whole life. Yeah, but I was going to say over the last week about how poorly he enunciates and also just struggles to find the right words. And the other day he was talking to his son, and we were actually over the headset playing some Xbox. And he turns to his son, he's like, boy, you ain't making lies.
You're making lies.
Fucking hick. Okay, alright, so here's my summing it up in a tweet. Jimmy comes clean to the gals at Sandpiper. Nacho takes down Hector and doesn't need a sniper. Kim begins to turn her life around. Chuck's gonna burn one down. Nice. And that is summing it up in a tweet. Can I just say I'm fucking embarrassed by the number that I gave that?
Thank God.
Like, and then we talked for just a quick second right there as we had paused to come back into this segment and like to see like who we wanted to start with. And you jokingly said, how about Mike? And I'm like sitting here fucking blown away.
Favorite character, not even.
That is fucking horrible.
Did you make a cameo?
Did I hate the finale?
I was not a fan. I mean, I gave it a 6, and I thought I was being generous.
Wow. That really, I guess, shows recency bias. Like, I came out of it with just, like, the last scene of the flames
Exactly. Licking
across the windows, and I thought, oh, that's fucking huge. And then now I'm like, you mentioned that, and I'm like, Jesus fucking. And then we were like, okay, well, what plot line do you want to follow? Which one was the least interesting? It's like, take your fucking pick.
Exactly.
Wow.
Uh-huh. I mean, I can't even think of something that jumps out at me. I don't even know where I want to start.
Okay, well, all right. Let's just start at the beginning.
Kim slowly recovering. Chuck looking for wires. I mean, what the fuck is this episode about?
So Jimmy's main arc at the end of this season was him coming clean about something that he only started doing last episode.
Yes. Just to help one old person. Mind blown, Vince Gilligan.
Wow.
Checkmate.
That's goddamn crazy.
Yeah, it is.
Okay.
It's almost as goddamn crazy as your ranking of it. It can only get half a point better than this, guys. I want a different show.
Okay, all right. So there were parts that I liked. So if it was a regular episode, I guess. Yeah. But so Chuck addressing the board at HHM, he's going through all the options. Well, first, there's a lawsuit.
Smarmy piece of shit.
Bad reputation. Yeah, he is super smarmy. The casting for him, I feel like, is great because he does a really good job portraying it, don't you think?
Side note, do you know who cast him? You know why he's in the show at all?
Vince Gilligan?
Nope. Guess
who?
Again.
Bryan Cranston?
Ding, 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 ding.
What?
Yeah.
What? How do you know that?
I know everything there is to know about Saul.
How long have you known that?
I've actually held on to that
Jables,
nugget.
How long have you known that?
four episodes.
God damn it.
I'm sorry.
Why?
Saving it for the finale.
I don't understand. We're sitting there. We're struggling with our numbers. We're only hitting 80,000, 90,000 downloads an episode.
Oh, no.
You know, we could have easily crept up to six figures if you just started dropping truth nuggets.
Well, I got a bunch of them, so.
Do you really?
No.
That's it?
Never mind.
This is basically like the finale of the show. Like, they hit all their big strides in the middle and then fucking shit their bed in the finale. So I really like that. Okay, so there's the lawsuit is one thing, the bankruptcy, or option three, we put it behind us with a simple handshake.
Oh, God. Howard,
I'm sorry, everybody. Can you get in the room?
It was much more like, I'm sorry, everybody. Can you leave the room, please?
Your fucking Howard voice is the shittiest.
Whatever.
It's not much better than, or not much worse than mine, but I basically, like, he chastises the tits off of Chuck right
fucking
here.
Fucking rightfully so, too.
Yes.
Not even just my personal hatred
no,
of
no,
Chuck.
No. He basically says,
everything
like,
you say is right
most
on the
of the
mark.
Time we spent, you know, you were invested in this, and we built it up together, and the firm is what mattered, and, it, you know, we took it from nothing to this great thing, and it is. It's impressive.
He says, in what world is it anything but basically you being a fucking asshole backstabber?
Yep, exactly.
And only in Chuck's world is that not what exactly happened.
Yep, and then it turns out he paid him out of his own fucking
yes,
money with some loans, but
check.
Basically, like, is paying him out of his own fucking money.
I bet there's at least a part of Howard that wishes that Chuck handled the same... handled being handed a check the same way that Howard did. When Kim gave him the check,
oh, ripped
he
it
rips
up.
It up,
okay,
so he
gotcha.
Hands him a check for $3 million. I bet a little bit of him was hoping he'd slash that.
Gotcha.
I know, great setup, I know.
Poorly phrased, tenuous connection, but it made sense afterwards.
Sweet.
Okay. What's going on down there?
Nothing, dude, just dancing.
I just don't know about you sometimes.
I'm trying to unwind from the fucking anxiety attack you gave me earlier today.
I know,
I you did that to me.
You do seem like your face is still
it's
red.
Fucking rude.
That was a good punishment, though, right?
Yeah, I can't wait till
I know
next
you
fucking
well,
show.
I know you well enough to hit you with something
yeah,
that's going to make
before
you uncomfortable.
All my punishments I made just cheeky and fun, so we had some good stuff.
This one only lasted 4 minutes. Didn't require hours of prep off air.
Yeah, I'll
like
be
that.
Talking about this with my therapist for years to come.
Oh, God. Okay, so anyway, I thought it was great that Howard then basically gives him no wiggle room, walks him out where everyone is assembled
waiting.
On all three floors.
Crazy.
And basically like announces his retirement, and Chuck walks out having to basically smile and play nice.
That's great.
Yeah, and then I just let's just walk through his thing a little bit. So he starts melting down after the thing with Jimmy. So Jimmy comes by to apologize.
Fuck Chuck. God
yeah.
damn.
Yeah, so Jimmy comes by to apologize, and at first he's having second thoughts, but he finally ends up walking in, and it does not go well. So at first he comes in, and he's shocked. Like, everything, the power's on. There's music playing. Like, the house has some life in it now. And
so do you think that Chuck knew Jimmy was going to come by, or what was he doing? What was the purpose of that? Why did he have the lights on?
He was doing better.
And then lost it when he told his brother off?
I think it was the combination of severing that last tie, but also the HHM thing. I think that he was all probably going to start spiraling downwards regardless.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I think it was the combination of the two.
It would have been really nice if Jimmy came over and he was already fucking out of his mind. Although Jimmy probably would have helped him. And
that's
he
the problem.
Better. So yeah, I'm glad.
That's what needed to happen here in that order.
Right.
Okay, so then what did he say to Jimmy at some point?
I don't want to hurt your feelings.
But the truth is, you never mattered all that much to me.
Poor Jimmy. All he wants, just like me wanting Rob's attention, is just his big brother's approval. I mean, me and Jimmy are in the same fucking boat. And both of our staunch, hard-ass older brothers never show us the love.
Wow.
Shout out to you,
so
Rob
true.
Job. I know you're listening.
Oh, that's funny. Okay, so, I mean, anything else come out of that scene? He's basically telling Jimmy, why are you putting yourself through this? Why do you feel bad? And then you think, oh, that's kind of nice. Like, he's basically going to... And he essentially is saying bygones are bygones. But then he's kind of telling him, like, just, like, lean into it. You
just
know
be
that,
the cretin that you are.
Yeah, this is who you are. It doesn't matter. You're always going to destroy the people around you.
Yep.
And there's no need for you to go and play nice afterwards. I have no doubt that that is a true emotion of yours. And what is awful is it's all true.
Yeah,
it is 100%. All 100% true.
Yeah.
Now, a lot of that is with the benefit of having seen the future path of Saul Goodman.
Right.
But, I mean, it is 100% true. He absolutely fucking ruins everything around him. He's reverse Midas and, like, essentially just goes around destroying everything.
Except for what he did with Thelma.
Irene.
Just throw an old lady's name.
Guaranteed that bitch dies somehow next season because of something he does. Yeah. Like, she gets the money and she does, like, too much blow and dies or something like that.
I thought that catnip was going to be marijuana and the cats go crazy and scratch her.
That's so weird. That would be the worst episode of Better Call Saul ever, other than maybe this one.
You'd probably give it a 10.
Nice. Goddamn. Zing.
Oh, nice.
Oh, what? Fucking
doing zings.
Synchronous zinging. Oh. Okay, so then it gets to the fucking meltdown scene. There's, like, scattered jazz music playing in the background, and it starts off pretty simple. He flips off the lights. He calls the power company because the meter keeps turning even after he's done it.
What phone operates with no power like that? Like, how did he call anywhere? He flipped off all the breakers, and his phone works, and he's wondering what's generating that little bit of power. Probably the fucking phone?
Yeah, but then... I get what you're saying. That's a great point. I don't know how phones work.
I don't know how phones work! Well, they need electricity. I mean,
for sure.
I mean, how else is it going
to
work?
I mean, to be fair, he does put it down like it's hurting him afterwards. I was thinking, to me... when I was watching the scene, because that flittered through my mind, and then I just excused it of, like, well, there's a million different ways that you could look at it. Like, he just very quickly flipped on one breaker, plugged it in, and made the call. True. And then unplugged it, turned it off, and flipped the breaker back off.
Yeah, I suppose. I don't know, I didn't like it. Even when he was wrapping it up, he was wrapping the phone cord around the phone, but that was just, like, the modem cord. That wasn't, like, an electricity source.
That's the first thing he did, but I'm sure he unplugged it all the way.
I didn't see it.
And even if he didn't, then maybe he still left it plugged in, but then went back and flipped the last breaker.
Perhaps.
Okay, I just feel like this does not matter.
There was dust on that phone.
Oh, God. That's a Walking Dead reference, because Jables, for whatever reason, gets hung up on these stupidest details.
Continuity flaws drive me nuts.
He gets so pissed in Walking Dead because they work so hard on building out these sets with, like, vegetation. There's kudzu growing out over fucking...
You love talking about that fucking kudzu. It was mentioned on, like, 3 podcasts.
The kudzu. It's growing over everything. Jables doesn't care about anything going on except that there's too much... No, there's not enough dust on everything. Right?
No, there was dust on the cars that had been sitting out for years and it had rained. People were pushing them. There was no handprints or anything on it. It was just covered in dust as if... A sandstorm had gone by Georgia just before they got there.
They're living through the dust bowl.
Yes.
Okay, all right, that doesn't matter. So Chuck melts down. Not only is he unplugging everything, he's taking all the light bulbs out, he's fucking wrecking the house. The house, when it's all done, is completely trashed.
It looks like fucking
trashed.
Swiss cheese. It looks like some of the houses I have to go inspect when the squatters fuck them up.
Yeah, basically.
It was crazy.
I mean, completely trashed, and then essentially it ends with him. He's just kicking at the table, the lantern sitting there. Who called it first?
You did.
Yeah.
Who was up at the TV blowing, trying to get that lantern over faster? Me.
So anyway, that's how it ends.
You think he's gonna die? You think that's the end of Chuck, or you think he's just gonna get fucked up, or what?
I think that it should be, and that would be terribly disappointing and take all of the fucking wind out of this on any kind of rewatch or something like that, to know that he survives this. Like, if the cliffhanger of the end of this season
is him,
of the only thing that happened
scare
in this episode of any note, other than maybe Hector going down. What if season 4 starts and Hector has recovered and is not in the catatonic type state that we know him to be in yet, and Chuck is fine too?
I'd be fucking pissed.
There's no way, right?
No. No.
In other shows, yes, but I feel like Vince Gilligan and all them, they take their craft seriously.
Yeah, I mean, I'm still shocked at how...
lackluster it
was. Yeah, what a dud of an episode this was.
I feel you.
I even said the episode before this one, which was fucking great, that I didn't rate that the 9 or 9.5 that I wanted to, because I was fucking putting all my money on this being a blowout spectacular thing.
I agree. I expected more.
Yeah.
I mean, more. Okay, so let's talk about then what was good. So Salamanca's thing wrapped up, right?
Yeah.
And
I didn't like...
let's just talk about the Salamanca thing real quick.
Well, it was kind of towards the end of the Salamanca thing, but when Nacho is tailing fucking Hector to the thing and then gets out with a gun like he's going to fucking shoot him, and stuff like that. That is 100% what we were talking about before with just audience pandering. Because, well, first off, I love how he's wicked far away and aiming this little pistol.
Yeah.
Like he's going to be able to snipe him from inside the thing. Secondly, the guy rolls up and he's like, hey, oh, you got your message. Yeah, 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 I'm here. So why was he out with a pistol drawn and then puts it away when the other guys show up? Like, if he got the message, he knew they were coming.
I don't think he did get the message. I think he was trying to play it off like, yeah, that's the reason I'm here, not to kill Hector.
Oh, so it was just coincidental?
Yes. Like, they just happened to show up.
I like that even less.
I know, yeah. Like,
fucking A.
Really big coincidence.
Oh.
I know, because it doesn't feel real that that all would have played out just at that moment.
Yeah, I'm shocked even more. I want to lower it down to a fucking 5.5.
I mean, but that is for sure what was happening. He was pretending like he had been there for
So his plan was to snipe him with a pistol?
Yes.
Jesus Christ, Vince, what are you doing?
And so Gus comes, and our only scene with Gus, which, again, no scenes with Mike, period.
A
fucking no-show in the season finale.
Yeah. There was a huge fucking cliffhanger. Whose body did he find out in the desert with the metal detector? We just have to wait till next fucking season?
I'm still, my theory, and I know it doesn't really make sense either.
Is that Black Girl's husband? Yeah. Even if that was, they never mentioned it, so we don't know for sure.
Oh, it's of zero significance. That's for sure.
I don't understand. I'm so angry.
I'm very disappointed too. But I felt bad for Nacho this episode because his dad will never forgive him.
Oh no. If his dad makes it out of all this.
Yeah, exactly. Imagine being the dad. Mm-hmm. You play straight and narrow your whole life.
And it sounds like you build
up this little business of yours. You have your corner of the world that is yours and yours alone. Nobody can take it away from you. You do everything by the book so you have no fear of retribution or the government. Mm. And your scumbag kid brings in one of the biggest cartel drug pin one of the top dudes, and then instantly that dude just throwing,
and you have to bow down to him.
How much money do you think that was? $400 maybe?
No, it was more than that.
He was peeling off 50s.
They were 50s.
Maybe it was $1,000.
I'd say $1,000 maximum.
But to completely
risk everything you've ever built and just walk in here like you own it, I mean, definitely a huge slap in the face.
For a grand.
And like you said, with his father never forgiving him, because it sounds like they alluded to Nacho kind of getting mixed up with some shit before, but made it, at least to his dad, seem like he straightened himself out.
Agreed.
And is on the up and up.
Yeah.
And now he relapsed. So.
The ultimate backslide do, for sure.
See, backslide do?
Yeah.
Nice fucking reference, dude.
especially for you. You didn't have to call out the reference. You could have just chuckled.
I
want to
make sure
on.
That you said backslide do. That's good stuff.
Okay, so we don't need to talk about that anymore. Let's throw over to our season finale, Jib Jab with Jables, a little song that you prepared, I believe. Mm-hmm. And then when we come back from it, we can talk about Jimmy and Kim's plotline.
Yeah, her arm slowly healing. Yeah, should be great content.
Okay, here's Jib Jab with Jables.
Jib Jab. Ladies and gentlemen, Jib Jab with Jables.
All I can say is that this episode was lame. I hate to complain, but it was plain Jane. And all I hope for, even though this one was a bore, is that in season four there's more in store. For sure. I just wonder why they didn't include my. He's clearly the one the fans like. slipping, Jimmy came clean. But old lady clicks, that can't be me. And I'm so sad for Wex, whose sleepiness caused the wrecks. She seems so damn perplexed and thinks, what's next? Hector takes a fall, those heart pills did not work at all. And Chuck's crazy soon returns, but in the end he burns. Chuck burns. Chuck burns. Chuck burns.
Get your free month trial to Audible at www.audibletrial.com/boobtubebuddies. Why the funky beat, you ask? I wanted to download the book Making Music Your Business, a guide for young musicians, but first, I wanted to see if I have what it took to
make music.
English, motherfuckers!
I guess some of us just don't got it. I'll stick to podcasting and never do anything like this again. Seriously, swear to God I won't. If you go to www.audibletrial.com/boobtubebuddies, it's a free month for you and money in our pockets. Over 180,000 titles to choose from, like Making Music Your Business, a guide for young musicians. Drop the beat, little buddies.
Okay, so first off, thank you so much for all the songs throughout the season. That was fun doing the duet last week. I've liked to have done a duet again this week, but you refused to do one with me.
I refused to do one. My creative juices weren't flowing until an hour before the episode. So.
You day trading Rocket League son of a bitch.
You got me into that. That's your fault.
No, first off, Jeffy got us into that. Okay, too many inside references. Just, nobody gives a shit about
just you
this.
And I, too. It's not even inside with our close group of friends. It's just things that only you and I would understand.
Actually, I do. Okay, so first off, you had a. I know that you had a one last Chuck joke, and since we're moving on from it.
Not necessarily a joke. I just.
No. It's a joke.
You want me to set up the hilarious joke?
Yeah.
All right, you set it up. I'll knock it down.
Okay, so Chuck's going through his house. He's knocking holes in the wall everywhere.
Here's Chucky. So it's worth going back.
Totally worth it.
But I might add, while we're back in the scene, why is he wearing disc gloves during this... the renovation? Like, he doesn't have any
workman gloves yard gloves,
dainty ass yellow fucking ladies dish.
I think
gloves.
We've seen that before on him though.
Really?
It seemed familiar.
Maybe when he was washing the dishes. Not pulling concrete and shit.
Whatever, dude, he sucks. Good riddance.
Fuck Chuck.
Let that motherfucker burn.
Burn, mother chucker.
Burn, mother chucker. Okay, all right, so let's talk about the Jimmy plot line, or what there was
lack thereof
of it. Well, it's not lack thereof, because they were in the whole goddamn episode. It was huge with Jimmy seeing just nothing of any impact whatsoever. Yeah. So we have Kim waking up at the hospital, or she's in the hospital. Jimmy finally gets there. And then they go pick up the papers that spilled out of the car. No digital copies? No, just that's it? The paper copies that are in the desert?
And luckily, she happened to crash a car in a sealed vacuum. There was
none of them kept
there,
blowing around.
There was zero wind that moved all the papers. She had already been to the hospital, stitched up, full cast, dried all that. I mean, that has to be at least minimum.
Yeah, six to
8 hours.
Yeah, probably more, but at least six.
And all those papers were just still fucking there.
Yeah, that's it. Perfectly preserved.
Silly as shit.
Okay, whatever. So then, I don't know. I don't really want to talk about the Kim waking up and the eggs and bakey scene. Nothing important there.
That was cute. I like that.
Well, okay, so whatever. It's a nice moment between them at the house.
It's sweet. Listen, Jimmy's about to turn into just full-blown asshole, so I really like these flashes.
Soak up these moments. Okay, it was... That is an enjoyable scene, but what is there to parse through?
Yeah, I guess not much. Do you think
you're
that,
right, though. It does need to be mentioned that those scenes do make up the show. So us skipping over them in an episode where we're just shitting on it
right.
is doing a little disservice to
their,
the good parts.
They're, you know...
And we haven't had many for a few episodes because she's been so busy with doing her thing.
Very true.
He's been so busy scamming old ladies and freaking Wang
doing
down.
What he does.
Corking bingo balls.
Oh, no.
Corking bingo balls. Okay, yeah, that worked. It didn't sound right, but okay. So then Kim and Francesca at the house. She is... starts hustling like she's gonna make this deadline, then all of a sudden has her aha moment right. and decides, you know what, let's pass that one along.
What's
and
important?
They go to Blockbuster Video, which is kind of funny, and she picks out 9 movies and ends up rewatching
10.
Oh, she did grab a 10th. You're absolutely Whee! Right. How many is that? 9. Perfect. Reaches and grabs another, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so she watches To Kill a Mockingbird a bunch of times. They have a quick...
Which I always thought was President Snow's job. Oh, that's Mockingjay.
I can't do this with you. It's so bad. It's
you see my
so
smug
bad.
Face when I was setting up
yeah,
this joke?
I
like I'm
it.
Knocking a fucking home run out
well,
of the park.
What I don't understand, whenever you come up with a good joke, and I swear to God it's not to be funny, you instantly teapot... You're,
I really do.
Yeah,
what is that?
Every time your hand balls into a fist, it goes onto your hip.
I've got something
to
say.
You put your shoulder up on that side too, dip the other one down, and then your hand on the other side goes out.
When I get all stand up, I will shout.
I can't do this with you right now.
It took everything in me to not do it.
Christ. Oh my God. Okay, so now what is there to talk about here? Do we just skip all the way forward then to the chair yoga scene? Let's do it. Fuck it.
Yeah, fuck it all.
All right, fuck it all. So the chair yoga scene was really funny.
I liked
Actually,
it.
Very enjoyable. Yes. Really enjoying it. Jables, will you do it with me real quick? Cat? Cow. That's it.
With me, it's more like hippopotamus, elephant.
Oh my God.
I'm fat.
Why do you do this
for the
to
listeners
yourself?
That can't
Why
see me?
Why do you do this to yourself? All right, we're going to start doing chair yoga while we podcast from now
we
on.
We couldn't because I couldn't even do cat. I bent over and my tummy stopped me.
Cool.
You wonder why I don't have Brighton Bay listening to my podcast.
Okay, stop. All right, so that's when Aaron from HHM shows up, and basically they set up this stage thing outside, and it's pretty obvious instantly, because when you see him
right.
wearing the thing, you know that's what's
uh-huh,
happening, right? 100%. Was there any part of you that wasn't
immediately? Not even for a second.
Okay, cool. And so essentially they all hear the thing, they're aghast, you know, cue the fucking, gasps. And so then he walks back inside. They basically tell him off. Irene's back in, Jimmy's out. And, I don't, anything there either.
I like that he did it. It's definitely the right thing to do. I was feeling fucking terrible for Irene, but I mean, like he said, he fucking just threw his livelihood and career just out the window just so this old lady can pal around with her friends for another 2 years.
And I think a part of it was in response to his conversation with Chuck, because Chuck was saying, you don't build things, you just tear things down.
Right.
And then Kim was saying, play to your strengths, and I think that triggered that for him,
right.
and he realized, well, honestly, to build things, you do have to tear things down first.
Down. Yep.
And so that's what he did. He tore down his own reputation so that he could build back up Irene. So it was a really nice altruistic moment that he had. So maybe Jimmy can change. That's the note we end the season on, I guess. And then they go to pack up their little office, which, by the way, where will they stinkle pop?
Oh, no. What's a pop without a stinkle?
Oh, God. What's a stinkle to a pop? Right?
Yeah, I love it.
Okay. So they bid farewell to poor old Francesca, who has to go back to the MVD. Definitely felt bad for Francesca.
We'll see her again.
You think so?
That's his secretary in Better Call Saul.
Oh, my God.
That's
I'm
Francesca.
So stupid.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. I literally never realized
really?
That. No, because
oh,
I've
wow.
never... Since I started... Better Call Saul. Oh, that's not true. No, I did go back and watch Breaking. Oh, but that was after the second season. She was only introduced this season.
I don't know. I don't know when she
this season? She was introduced this season because we were covering it. We were not covering last season. True. I remember the MVD meeting conversation.
Okay,
so.
But yeah, that's his full-time secretary. So at some point, you know, when he starts being Saul Goodman, has his own thing, he does pluck her out.
And, that's a great point. Okay, thank you.
Told you I had truth nuggets all day long.
I guess so, but that was only in response to my idiocy.
Yeah, I love how
everybody else knows that.
I don't know about that.
All right, write in. We want to hear what you guys think.
Nobody ever writes in anymore. We ask people write in all the time. They never give me answers.
People write in all the time. I just don't tell you about it.
Share me about them.
You don't want to hear what they have to say.
If they're talking about my singing again, I'm going to pull a Chuck.
Everybody's talking about your singing.
I'm burning this fucker to the ground.
Jable's going to burn one down.
Do they really talk smack?
No, nobody talks.
Those fucking YouTubers do. I know they.
They really don't. Everybody likes what you're doing.
Yay. Yeah.
After we did the NSYNC one, I mean, like, it happened.
We made it?
Nobody wrote in.
Oh, no. Piece of shit.
Nobody liked it. Nobody gives a shit. I show it to people and they give me like the nice smile and the nod. Nobody fucking cares.
Oh, no.
It doesn't matter. Hundreds of millions of downloads every fucking episode and
nobody
cares.
Can say a fucking thing.
I love that the number grows exponentially every time.
Well, then I'll keep my references to just pleasing you because you're the only one that gives me feedback.
That's true.
You guys want to write in? I'll start spreading the fucking love.
How about a little conditioning here? And then that's it. He throws away the Rolodex. She pulls it back out. You never know. And then that's it. That's the season. I mean, obviously Chuck's burn it down scene is afterwards. But so let me ask you, scale of 1 to 10. What did you think about the season?
I'm going
to
give it a 9.75.
Okay.
I'm sticking with my fucking 6.
Yeah, for the whole season?
The season.
Yeah.
Oh, the season, I mean, it was great. There's lots of... It sucks because this whole thing took the wind out of my sails. I mean, it was going along. I was fucking really excited about it. And then...
I don't know if you can have a great season with a terrible and bland finale.
That's what I'm saying. It definitely, the worst taste in my mouth ever.
Was it that great?
I mean, there was great moments. There was great plots and funny times.
I think any good show that has a bad season is going to have good moments.
Yeah.
I don't think that this was a very good season.
I mean, yeah. Definitely left the sour taste in my mouth, too. I mean, I'd say overall the season, I'd still give it a 7.
Yeah.
Yeah. But that's not saying much. I fucking love Saul. I mean, last season was fucking dynamite.
Okay, so I am going to reinstate the punishment, and you have to finish the outro hosting duties. That's pretty easy,
I'm
right?
I'm comfortable as shit.
Okay, because I've literally never once in the history of Boob Tube Buddies
tied a bow.
Exactly.
Holy shit! Well, all right. Well, we're gonna wrap things up here, folks. Why are they folks? Why do I turn into this person when I'm on the spot? I can't just be normal. All right, so just sign on up to my Patreon page. It's jablesmorales.com. I'm not Spanish.
It's patreon.com/BTB, I think. Maybe /BoobTubeBuddies.
Excuse me, guest. I got this.
For less than the price of a cup of coffee. I don't know why you're doing that voice.
Am I? It's my Hamlin.
You're definitely talking like this.
I can tell because my teapot's out. Yeah, oh, no.
Yeah, the teapot's been out the whole time.
Well, to stave off any more embarrassment, Foxman, why don't you first tie a... tie a bow on this bitch.
It's been really fun covering this season with you. Thank you guys so much for listening. We'll see you next season, little buddies.